Hello everyone, DonellHD here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up, configure, and install the Sony PSP Emulator PPSSPP on Launchbox. As per usual, I have my arcade folder here, and inside that folder I have my Emulators folder, my Launchbox folder, and the ROMs folder where we're going to be keeping our ROMs. I left the link in the description below for everything that you're going to need to get set up right away. All you have to do is click here on download. Alright, I've downloaded the PSP Necessities file and I placed it here on my desktop. What we're going to do now is extract the contents of it into the emulator folder. So I'm going to open it up here and I'm going to simply drag and drop into the emulators folder. Alright, I'm going to run the emulator for the first time. So I'm going to click here. I'm going to click on the PPSSPP Windows 64. Depending on your version, if you're using 64-bit, you choose that as well. But if you're using the 32-bit, then you would choose the other version here. Once it loads up, it's going to look something like this. If you'd like, you can go ahead and direct it to where your games are. Once again, mine is on the desktop, arcade, ROMs folder, and then click OK. Your game should load up here. You can pretty much leave everything else alone. I'm using the Xbox One controller, and once I plugged it in, PPSSPP automatically detected it and configured it for me. I'm going to click exit here now, and now we're going to set this emulator up in Launchbox. Alright, now that we're here in Launchbox, we're going to go to the three lines at the top left corner here. We're going to go to Tools, Manage, Emulators. We're going to click Add. The name of our emulator is PPSSPP. Now I'm going to set the path. Once again, it's on my desktop, Arcade, Emulators folder, PPSSPP, and the PPSSPP Windows 64 executable here. Whether you're using 32-bit or 64, you choose your version. I'm going to go to Associated Platforms and make sure that it's set for Sony PSP here. I'm going to make sure this is set as my default emulator. Now I'm going to go here to the running script area. And I left the script in the description below that if you require it, it allows you to escape out of the emulator easily by pressing the escape key. I'm just going to paste that here. Now I'm going to click OK and then close. Now it's time to add our games. I'm doing the drag and drop method here, so I'm going to open my ROMs folder. And I'm going to simply drag them into Launchbox like so. What type of game files are we importing? We say ROM files. What platform are you importing games for? Make sure you say Sony PSP. Next, manually configure emulator. Make sure you select manually configure emulator. Choose an emulator, make sure it says PPSSPP here. Next, use the files in their current location. Next, 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 next. Make sure your games are spelled correctly, and then click Finish. Alright, now that we've imported everything, it's time to test out our games. We're going to go right here to Split Second. And upon loading the emulator for the first time, it will be in small screen. Press the Alt and Enter key, and it will automatically maximize it, and it will stay that way until you press that key again. And here is gameplay from Split Second. And here is Killzone Liberation. Thank you everyone for watching. If this video helped out at all, support the channel and drop a like and subscribe. I've created many tutorials for other platforms as well. Just follow the thumbnails on the screen. As always, I'm DonellHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.